Hello everybody, my name's Walter, and in this tutorial I'm gonna show you how you can build my 12 block high, supercharged and infinitely expandable slime door. Be aware that this door needs a lot of space and a lot of resources. For the space, just know that the door is 11 blocks deep, goes 9 blocks below the floor, 9 blocks above the ceiling and needs an extra 6 blocks to one side for the main circuits. Now for the resources you need a lot of sticky pistons. The action number depends on how wide your door is, 2 normal pistons, 2 droppers, at least 3 hoppers, a lot of redstone, a couple of redstone repeaters and comparators. Again, the number depends on how wide your door is, a few redstone torches, at least 1 lever and a few buttons. Then you will need a normal building block that can be pushed by pistons and slime blocks, a building block that can't be pushed by pistons and slime blocks, like obsidian. Then you're gonna need a lot of slime blocks, so I would actually suggest you build a slime farm before starting with this one here. And finally, a few blocks of glowstone. So much for the resources. Now let's start with the tutorial. Okay, the first thing you've got to do is decide where your door should be and how wide it should be. In this case, I want my door where these blocks are, and it should be 13 blocks wide. Now go to one corner and go down 8 blocks, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Take out those blocks and place a row of 5 sticky pistons like this. Now place another sticky piston on top of this. Take out the block, you don't need it anymore. Place 5 slime blocks like this and 6 slime blocks going all the way up here. Now place a normal block here, go 1 block down. Now to grab some obsidian and make a little stair like this, going all the way to here. Make the same stair on the other side. Okay, now place 5 normal blocks like this, and we got ourselves our first module. Just repeat the same process over and over till you're at the last block, and the modules are done. As you can see, I left out the last row of normal blocks here because I'm going for an odd number of blocks. So if you have an even number of blocks, just place another row of normal blocks here and you're fine. But as I already stated, I'm going for a 13 block wide design, and so I'm stopping with this row of slime blocks. Okay, now go to the back of this. Place normal blocks like this. Then grab some obsidian and place them like this. Next, place redstone on top of those blocks. Then place a normal block up one like this. And another row of normal blocks like this. Grab some redstone repeaters, place them like this. Make sure they are all on one tick. We need another one here. Then place a sticky piston here with a normal block on top of it. Then place some redstone on top of these blocks here. Now we go up one again. And place some redstone on top of these blocks too. Next, we need some glowstone. place them on top of this. And also on these blocks we put some redstone. Okay, that's the back. Now we're connecting the front of the modules. For that, go one up here. Now place some redstone on those stairs here. You don't need redstone on the topmost obsidian block here. Then grab some redstone comparators and put them down like this. Make sure they look in the same direction as the repeaters we placed here. And the modules are now connected. The next thing to build is the control circuit. So go 2 blocks further from here and 6 blocks in this direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now place 5 blocks like this. Grab some redstone and put them down like this. Another 2 here. Now we need redstone comparators. Place 4 like this. Make sure they're all on the subtraction mode. Place 2 redstone repeaters like this, both on 2 ticks. Now place another block here and another normal block here. Put a redstone torch here, then put a redstone torch here. Now grab a sticky piston, place it here with an iron block with a normal block on top of it, and go out 3 blocks here. Place some redstone torch and for the moment a button. Now we've got to put this circuit here in the right state. The right state is when those comparators are turned on, but this redstone here isn't still powered. So we need, if I remember correctly, 6 pulses here. And now you see the comparators are on, but this piece of redstone here isn't. So next, go up with 2 blocks here, then another 2 blocks. Place a piece of glowstone on top of this torch here. Go out 2 normal blocks further. Go up 1 block. And in this direction 4 blocks. And another block up here. Then 2 blocks like this and 2 blocks here. Another block on top of this. Now we place some redstone here for pieces, and here another few pieces. Next, a redstone repeater on 2 ticks and 4 redstone repeaters. Make sure they're all on the default setting. Next, place 3 normal blocks here, then go up 1 and place 2 blocks here and another 2 blocks here. Now grab some redstone and place it here. Next, put a normal block up here. Grab a normal piston facing this direction here. Then a sticky piston behind this normal piston facing upwards. Next, place a normal block here. Go over this redstone here and place another 2 blocks. Then go up 1 block and place another block down here. Place a normal redstone repeater here on the default setting. Place a block here. Go a block one up here. Place another redstone repeater here. Now connect this wire here with redstone and connect it down to here. Good. Next, place a normal block on top of this repeater here. Go 2 blocks further. A normal block here. Another normal block here. and here. Now a block above this gap here and another block here. Grab a comparator, place it here and set it on the subtraction mode. A piece of glowstone here, redstone here, and another few pieces of redstone here. Now place two repeaters. This one here set on 2 ticks, this leaf on the default setting. In front of the 1 tick repeater, place a piece of glowstone. Next, place a sticky piston down here with an iron normal block hovering above it. Good. Now place four more blocks like this. Place 3 redstone like this. A block here to cut it off. Then place a comparator here. Now we need the dropper. Place it behind the comparator. Then put a hopper facing into this dropper. Then we are taking an output with a comparator from this hopper and run it into this block. Under this block, place a redstone repeater on the maximum setting. Place 2 blocks like this with redstone on top of those and torches like this. You should see now that the pistons here are extending. Next, place a block like this with a torch on the side of it. Good. Now take the output of this torch with a redstone wire, place a sticky piston with a normal block on top of it, take the output with a normal repeater, then go 2 blocks further here, place 2 redstone here. Next, go down 1 block, then up again. Then 3 blocks like this. Place some redstone here and a repeater here on the default setting. Now grab a repeater, sticky piston, place it here, and another sticky piston here, and place blocks directly in front of those. Good. The last thing you've got to do now is grab 5 items and place them in this dropper here. And if you put a button here, you should see that somehow... Oh, I forgot to place a redstone here. And you should see the whole circuit or door closing. Now it works really nicely, as you can see. Sometimes there's a piston bug involved here that leaves part of the door partially closed. What I mean is that the door just closes, opens to a certain point, and from this point on the modules stay at a certain height. I got lucky here, there's no piston bug, but if you have this problem, there's a really easy solution to this. You just have to modify this slice here. What I mean with modifying is the normal slice looks like this. One possibility you could try out is placing a block of glowstone here with redstone on top of it, or if this doesn't work, you could modify it like this. Just go out here and make a little zigzag with glowstone like this. Normally one of those two should do the trick. If you have a problem and neither does solve it, you have to try out whatever you can think of. Try replacing those obsidian, for example, with normal hoppers, or placing another block here. Just do whatever you can think of. But normally one of those three designs works. Okay, but in my case I'm lucky and don't have this problem, so it works really nice. Okay. The next thing to do is building the actual floor and the door frame. For this we'll begin with a small frame around the door. Make sure that every block that gets in contact with the slime blocks is made of obsidian or something with the same attributes. That also includes those slime blocks that, when the door is closed completely, are just below the floor. So make sure you place 5 of those blocks here. The rest can be made of normal blocks. Now for the door frame. It's actually easier to build it with the closed door. So we have here 6 blocks. Now we have to go up 6 more blocks like this and fill this with obsidian too. That same thing on the other side. Good. Now you should open the door again. Now for the connection between the bottom and the top part, place a sticky piston here. Then we need a bit of slime blocks. Place 12 blocks like this. Then place a normal block here. Another normal block up here. Some redstone on top of this. Place a normal block here to cut this redstone off. And a redstone repeater on 2 ticks here. This button isn't needed anymore. You could place it on the side if you want, but that's not really needed. So now place another pillar made of obsidian here. And you can now place a few buttons. And as you can see, the signal gets transmitted upwards and downwards. Good. Now we can close off the rest of the floor. Now for the ceiling. First, we mark where the door will be. Then we're gonna place some obsidian around like this and like this. Make sure you go 5 blocks in this direction, just like in on the bottom, at the bottom. Place 2 blocks of obsidian here, or the slime pillar will get stuck later on. Now fill in the rest. With normal blocks. And the floor and the ceiling are done. Now it's time to build the modules for the top part. For this, go to the corner of the top part of the door and replace this block with a slime block. Then go up 7 blocks, 4, 5, 6, 7, take out those blocks and place a sticky piston below this block. And then row of 5 sticky pistons on the side like this. Then you can take out this block here again and place 5 slime blocks like this. then place another 5 slime blocks above this one here, and 5 normal blocks like this. Then put a normal block here and build a little stair out of 4 obsidian like this, and the same thing on this side here. And that's one module. Now we've just have to repeat this process until we are here at the last module of the top part. And the modules are done. Note that yet again I've stopped with a slime block row. The reason for this yet again is that I have an odd number of blocks with. So, next, go to the back of this door and place some blocks like this. Put redstone on top of those. Then put a few normal blocks like this. Grab some repeaters and place them in those gaps here. Place a sticky piston here with a normal block on top of it. Then some redstone like this. Now place another block up here for each module. Put redstone on top of those two. Next, grab some glowstone and place those blocks here. Put some redstone on top of those two. Now grab a lever, place it here, turn it on, and put a repeater here. Put some redstone dust here, then put 2 normal blocks here with redstone on top of those. Good. Next, go up here and put a row of normal blocks like this. Then put redstone on top of those stairs here. Make sure the redstone goes all the way down. Yeah, komm schon. Then put repeaters like this in a row, and the modules are now connected. Now it's time to build the main circuit. For this, place 3 redstone in a row like this, then 2 blocks here with redstone on top of it, and go up 1 block again, place redstone here. Now place 5 redstone like this, going into this block with a redstone torch on the side of it, and a repeater on the maximum setting in this direction. Then place 2 blocks like this, put redstone on top of those, and repeaters on the side of torches on the side, side of those. Finally, a block on top of this repeater. Then put a block here with redstone on top of it, put a normal block here to cut the power off, put a sticky piston with a normal block here, then a block with a redstone repeater on the default setting here, a normal block here, then another block here, and finally another block here. Put 3 redstone on top of those, and that should do the trick. So now take a normal piston and place it here, then place a sticky piston behind of it, then place 5 blocks in a cross like this. and two redstone like this. Put three blocks up like this. With a comparator in this direction. And another comparator in this direction on the subtraction mode. Now, place three blocks like this, and another block here. Put redstone dust here, redstone dust here, a block up here to cut the power off, then a repeater on two ticks, a repeater on one tick. Put a sticky piston down here with a block hovering above it. Place a piece of glowstone here. Then a normal block up here. Put a normal block here to cut the power. Place some redstone. And the clock is done. Next, grab the dropper and place it behind this comparator here. Then grab the hopper, place it facing towards this dropper. Then place a piece of glowstone up here, another normal block like this. Then go up one again to each side here like this, and place redstone on top of those blocks. Next, place four blocks like this, another one, another four like this, and finally close the circle. Now place a redstone repeater on two ticks, followed by three on one tick, the same on the other side. Now place a normal block here, then a glowstone block, then two normal blocks. Place a repeater on the default setting here and connect it all with redstone here. Put a redstone here and finally another repeater here. Then connect it with two blocks and two redstone to the bottom part here. Good. Now place a block of glowstone above this redstone here. Put some redstone at top of it and above a normal block to cut off the wire here. Next, place a normal block here. In this corner, put a sticky piston. In front of the sticky piston, place two slime blocks. And finally, one block cutting off this wire here. Then, place a block above this repeater here, go out one block, and five blocks in this direction. Put a normal block here, and four blocks here. Now put a redstone repeater on two ticks here, grab some comparators, place them like this, put them all on the subtraction mode, put some redstone down like this. Now grab a hopper and place it behind this comparator. Then fill it to the brim with items. So the comparator here gives an output of 15 strength. Then place a normal block behind this comparator here and put a torch on it. Now place a block behind this comparator here. Go one down here, then one up again. Now one down again, one more down, then you go up again. And place a few more blocks like this, and finally a block around this corner here. Now place redstone on top of these blocks here, and a repeater here. Now take a lever and place it behind this repeater here. Now we have to set this circuit here in the right state again. The right state is when those comparators are on. But this redstone and subsequently this sticky piston here isn't powered. In this case we need four short ticks, pulses. And you see, the comparators are powered, but this block isn't. Now remove the lever and put some redstone dust down like this. Finally, go down here, place a normal block here with redstone on top of it, another normal block here, and take an output of this hopper here with the comparator here. Then take out this block here and put 5 items into the dropper. Replace the block you just destroyed. And finally, to try all out if everything works, place a button here. So the door opens and closes completely. As you can see, I already tried out this part here, and those two modules here didn't open and close completely. So by trying out a few things, I came up with those two designs that worked. In this design, I had to replace the top two obsidian with hoppers, because I used hoppers because they are immovable and transparent blocks. And here I went with the second design, third design I showed you earlier, and it works quite nicely. The rest works like it was before. Okay. So, and as you can see, the door closes and opens like it's supposed to. Now, finally, let's try out the whole thing. And it seems we have something wrong with the timing of the circuit. Oh, sorry, I told you 2 ticks here. This one must be on 1 tick. So now it should be working. And you see, yes. Okay, that was the tutorial for my 12 block high, supercharged and infinitely expandable slime door design. I hope you enjoyed it, and see ya!